What's going on, everyone? So today's video is sponsored by Wix, and I'm gonna show you how you can create your very own website utilizing Wix. So let's hop over to my computer and let me show you what we're gonna be building for today.
So as you can see here, we have the first section with a little fade animation, and this is a little small sentence that you can include basically showing what you do. And again, if you are not a fan of this particular section or the design, you can always go ahead and replace this with a completely different design. But here we go into the next section here, and this is an about section. So basically you have a picture and then a little paragraph just showcasing what you like. And also this website utilizes a smooth scroll effect. So what that means is whenever I click on any of the menu navigation items like this, so I'll click on about me, it'll actually scroll down to the section on your website nice and smooth. And then we can go and continue, so we can click on the services menu. And then here we got some fade-in animations as well as just some services that you provide. And if this is not necessary for your website, then you can definitely leave it out there. But again, if it is, then you can again get the idea for this. And then if we continue scrolling down, this is sort of like a testimonial section. So again, if you have any sort of features for that, you can include this in here. Also, if you aren't looking for this sort of thing, but you wanted to showcase like an image gallery or even just showcase some sort of visual, then again, Wix has a lot of templates that you can actually go and drag and drop onto your design, and then you can go ahead and customize it from there. And then the last section we have here is the contact section. And they also, the cool feature here is this little icon on the right. So if I click on here, and I've already tested it out, but basically you can send a message. So I just said hi right here. And then it does an auto reply where it asks people, whoever goes onto your website, if they want to ask you a message or contact you, and they can leave their information here. And also, when they do send a message, you will get an email notification as well as a little notification on the dashboard as well, showing you that somebody has reached out. So if that's something that you feel like would be beneficial to you, then that's perfect for this design as well. So without further ado, let me show you how to create your website using Wix. So in order to get started, you're going to need to navigate over to Wix's website. So I have a link in the description, so you can go ahead and access their website through there. And then once you see, you can get started. And then you'll have to go here to the sign up page and create an account if this is your first time using Wix. Or if you already have one, you go ahead and log in or go with Google or Facebook. So I already have an account, so I'm actually gonna go over to my dashboard and then show you how to create your site from there. So here I am logged into my account. So I'm just gonna click and create a new site. And then it's gonna ask me to choose between two different platforms. So we're just gonna go with Wix. And here it's gonna ask you what type of website you wanna create. So again, you can choose whichever one fits your needs, but for this example, we're gonna go with the business themes, and then we have two options here. And we're gonna go with actually choosing a template. So click this, and Wix actually has a lot of pre-built templates that you can go ahead and view and utilize. So if you wanted to check these out, you can check them out and then go ahead and edit them and use that as your website design. For this example, I'm gonna go here to consulting and coaching. Now just scroll down and then go to the second page and continue scrolling, and it seems like it's loading. And then right here, coaching professional, this one right there, and I can go ahead and click on edit there. So here we are on the Wix editor, so we can actually go ahead and start editing the website. Go here on this text and just click into it, and I can just go here and just change the text whatever I want. So I'll just put this, and then I'll say videographer based in LA. And then if you wanted to, you can actually change the color of this text here. So I'll just double click and highlight it and just change these to black. And then also if you wanted to change a specific word, you can also highlight it as well and then change it there. And then also I can shrink this sizing, and then also I can drag this. So I'll click out of it and then just highlight it and drag it over and then have it centered right there. And now here we have is the top is the navigation or header. So for instance, if you wanted to, you can go to the left side here and manage your pages, and you can see all of the different menu options we have right now. And then also up here we have page, and you can see all the different individual pages. So if you have a multiple page website, you can click on it and it leads you to and see a custom screen here. So if you wanted to, you can delete these sections and fill this in with your own design and content. But for our example, we're just gonna stick with the just single page for now. So what I can actually do is click on the Manage Pages tab down here, and then pretty much just go here to the three dots and delete the menu items that we're not actually planning on using. So we're gonna delete the plans for here, and then I'll go ahead and delete the rest of the options that I'm not gonna use. So here I have the three I left, so about me, services, and then let's talk. And if you want to change the name of these, you can double click into it and then just change it to contact or whatever you want to name it. Then click done, and we scroll back up, you can see that it's changed. Also, if you wanted to add a new menu, you can just click add page. And then as you can see, if I click it out of here, you can see that it's added onto there. So if you wanted to change that and add a new menu, you can go back and then just change this to, you know, new menu right there. And then I'll just update just like that, as you can see here. So for this, we don't need that. So I'll just go ahead and delete that really quick. Then also here we have this little login bar. So we don't need that for this design. So I'll delete this and I'll just drag this over right here. And then here is just like your website logo. So I'll just put this right there for mine. And then you can change the design, but I like the current one. So I'll keep it like this. And now we can go navigate to the next section here. So for here, if you wanted to, you can see the layout of your website by going to the tools. And then you can go here to layers and it'll show you individually each different section. So right now the header is the navigation on the top. This page is pretty much all of your body content. And then the footer is pretty much this thing. If I click out of it or click onto the footer, maybe you'll see it better. It's pretty much the footer down here. So if you wanted to, you can click on any of these. It's called a strip in Wix. And pretty much it is a section with content inside of it. So for this one, we're currently on this strip right here. So I'll just navigate and exit off here. Also, you can go down here to the layers button down here, and it also brings up the exact same tab. So in case you wanted to see the structure of your websites, this is the easiest way to do it. And then the last thing I'll show you really quick on the tools tab here is this rulers. So in case you wanted to have a particular design and align it perfectly, you can go and have these rulers show up and then just click into there, and then you can see you can like move this around. So depending if you have like text, also like these values here, and then you can move it around, position it according to your custom design. So here I'll just close this out. So for this section, I want to actually click into this and let's click into the actual column. So double click here and we'll just change this background image. And here I'm just going to use an image and I'll just go here. And then once it loads up, you have the way so you can upload your own custom images on your computer. So you click on upload media and then upload it from there. But for this example, I'm just going to utilize Unsplash, which is pretty much a website that allows you to use custom images and use that all over your website. So here I just type in videographer, now press enter. And then there's a picture I liked down here. See if it shows up. This one right here. So I just click it and then we'll change the background. And it was that simple and easy. Now, if you wanted to crop this, change the coloring, all of that fancy effects, you can go to the actual settings and mess around with this, or you can actually go to the three little lines right there and then crop it, resize it, enhance it, add filters, overlays, etc. So that's something if you needed that, but for here we don't really need that, so I'll just leave it empty and then I'll just exit off here. So here too we have this column two, so I'll go ahead and click on it, change the column background, and we can choose a color this time. I'll make it black to match. And then we have these container boxes here. So again, if you wanted to keep these, you can keep them, but for the example, I'm just gonna actually go into the tools and just go here to the layers tab. And then the cool thing is you can actually hide elements. So in case maybe in the future you wanted to showcase a design again and you still wanted to keep it for now just to test it out, you can actually click on it and then click on the eye and essentially hide it. So if you wanted to, you can have it like that, but I have it like that just in case in the future, I wanna change it back, then I'll keep it there just in case. And then here we can just click on this and I'll just change this to like, white background. So click it to the fill opacity and then just pretty much change this to the white version. And then here too for this arrow, if I click into the arrow, click the little brush looking icon, I can go to the border, click and then red, and then there we go. So here I'll just fill in my custom content I already added for the actual text. So I can just click in this paragraph, edit the text, and then I'll just paste in my content here. And then also if you wanted to, we can add animations. So for instance, right here, you click on this animations icon. And we can have it, for instance, float in. And then also if you want to customize this, floating in from the right, left, bottom, top, etc. Duration, delay, first time animates, all of that fanciness right there. You can go ahead and mess around with that. And also we can add a fade in animation on here as well. So I just click it. And this one's normal, so I just put the fade in there. And then here we have the services section. So right now we can actually go here and I can change this to, for instance, what I can do for you. And then here we can just put, for instance here, I'll just put videography. And then I'll go ahead and fill in the rest of this content here. Before we do, let's actually make sure we save this just in case you might have some work. And then for instance, something happens to your computer and then next you know it, you have to restart. So let's just save this really quick, and I'll just make this, I'll just go ahead and save it here, and then here I'll just go ahead and clean up this section here. So I'll just delete some of this stuff here and then fill out the rest of the content. And then also I'll change the design of these line colors and simply just add a red color here. So now we can scroll down to the next section. So here, this is pre-built by the template by default, but for instance, what if we don't like this or have no use for it? So we can actually go ahead and just delete this. And now we have this massive gap right here, but I actually want to fill this up with an actual custom section built in with Wix. So here we can actually go over to this add plus sign. And then here you have a bunch of different choices here. But for this one, let's go to the strip and then go to the testimonials. And then here I'm gonna actually go and just click on this one. And then it should just automatically place right on top. And now we have this section here. And also we have this massive gap here. So what let's actually do is, let's make sure everything's aligned. So let me just go ahead and just drag this thing all the way to the bottom of the most recent section. So I'll just keep dragging it up. And right now you can see the little line. This is the actual section. So we actually need to push this down a little bit. So let me just drag this down till it matches right there. And you can see we have the rest of the content coming up just like this. So that's perfect. And then also we can change this because this is an anchor point right here, this less talk, which is essentially, this controls the contact page right there. So this was the original navigation that scrolls down there. This is already pre-built into the template, so we don't have to sit there and add them ourselves. But that just basically tells it to scroll down to this section right there. So now let's go ahead and just change up the design here. So I'll just change these colors to black and then text white. So let me just do that really quick. And then for these images particularly, these are default, but if you want to, you can change it. And then we'll go here actually to the settings. And this is currently on the strip. So I actually want to click into the column and change actually the column itself. And now we can go here to the settings and then just basically change this one. I'll change this to black right there. And then I'll change the text and the content as well. So let me do that really quick for the rest of these. So I went ahead and finished up this section right here. And again, if you wanted to change this up, you can add additional sections here, pre-built ones, or you can create them from scratch. So it just depends on what your website needs. And then also go ahead and finish up this last section, the footer essentially, and the contact area. So I would go ahead and just change this strip background, put it to black, and then also these text here as well. Then if I click on the form, I can just design this and then customize it. And let's change the input first. So let's go with the text. And I actually want this color right here to be whites. And then also if we go back, we can change the submit button and we can change the text to black. All right, perfect. And then here's this bottom one, we can just go here and change this as well. So I'll just color it really quick. And then also here, I'll just edit this as well. So let's just save this really quick. Then also I want to add a little fade to right here as well. So we can go animation and just fade that in there. And now let me just show you the rest of the features on Wix's website. So here we have this background. So if you do have some specific background that you want to add for your page, then you can go ahead and add that here. And then here we already went through the custom content that Wix provides you for designing your website and all these other different features. And then also we click on this next one. This is a theme manager. So this is basically just theme colors for your website that you can actually go ahead and reutilize. You can also change the theme too. And then also here's the Wix app market. So this is essentially, name this as bonus additions to your website that you can enhance it with. So for instance, if you need to utilize email marketing with MailChimp, you can have this MailChimp Forms by MailMunch. And then additional apps here that you can go through like Google Ads and a bunch of different ones that you can go here and check out that fit your actual design. And then here we have this next one. So media, essentially uploading any of your assets onto here, such as images or videos. And then also we have this next section for the blog. So if you are planning on creating a blog or have blog posts that you want to share, then you can add this to your website as well. And then also we have this online booking section. So if you are, for instance, like a fitness instructor, dentist, doctor, whatever fits your ideal business needs or website needs, then you can go ahead and look into this feature as well. And then last we have is simply just marketing SEO and a bunch of cool features here as well. So one thing too, let's show you is the switch it to mobile just to see what your website looks like, just to make sure that it actually makes sense. So you can actually go through this little demo, but I'll just go ahead and skip this. And then we can just pretty much scroll through it and see, make sure everything's looking good. And as you can see, everything looks like it's nice and fitting. And then last but not least, you want to make sure you can publish your website too. So you can click on publish and I'll just publish it right there, and they can view the site too. And one last thing, I want to make sure we just add the little navigation, and I'll just design this right here. And for the custom design, I'll just go here to the clicked, change it to red. And this pretty much makes the actual text red depending on where you actually scroll. So now once you've decided on your complete design for your website, then you're gonna eventually want to have to upgrade it so that you can utilize your own custom domain and get access to all the premium features that Wix has. And you just go over here to upgrade and then simply just click on the upgrade now. And then Wix will showcase all of the different plans and pricings that they offer. So you can go ahead and choose which one fits the best needs for you. And then once you go out through the checkout process, you'll be set to go. And one last thing I forgot to add is the animations. So here, for instance, I had the animations on the original site showing it in essentially at one time. So you can actually click, since these are individual elements, you can actually hold shift and click on all three of them and group these elements. So let me do shift, click on three, group them, and now we can actually animate them. So here, let's just do a float in, except we'll customize this from the, let's do the left. And let's just play it, make sure. And I'll do the same thing here. I'll just shift, click, and group these. And then we'll do the same thing on the right. So this one should be by default. Yeah, right there. It has a little scroll effect here. Let's make sure. Click on it, fade in. There we go. And then we'll publish this. And now let's go ahead and just click on the final website and I'll refresh it and then show you what we just made. So again, here we have a little information section about us with the fade, and then the services section here, and then simple contact form right here.
So this completes the video for today. So if you haven't already, I'll put all the links down below so you can get started creating your very own website with Wix. And aside from that, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.